世界ってなんや。ようわからんわ。
If there is a film that reveals a working theory behind the cinema of Koreeda Hirokazu, it is his 1998 film, Afterlife. Unlike his other films, Afterlife is not set in this world, but in a way station for the dead. The dead have 3 days to choose a memory from their life. This memory will be turned into a film. After viewing this film, the dead will abide in this memory forever. While most of the dead struggle on what to decide, one girl immediately chooses a memory from Disneyland.
あれはスプラッシュマウンテンに乗ろうって言って。
Shiori, a caseworker's assistant, later finds the girl and encourages her to reconsider, which she does.
3歳くらいだったと思うんだけど夏でお庭に白い洗濯物が揺れててそれでお母さんの膝枕で耳掃除をしてもらっててその時のお母さんの匂いとか自分のほっぺがお母さんのももに当たってる感じとか覚えてて柔らかくってあったかくって。なんだかすごく懐かしい感じがしたから。あの、
何？
どうもありがとう。
まあ、ディズニーランドよりはマシなんじゃない？
うん。
This choice of the familiar over the fantastic is emblematic of Koreeda's own choices as a filmmaker. Koreeda consistently gives preference to the familiar moments of everyday life.Moments that often seem insignificant to the living. It is the context of death that gives these fleeting everyday moments value. Afterlife is also a film about filmmaking. And one can't help but think that Koreeda isn't also questioning the role of cinema and its relationship to this world.Does cinema offer escape from this world? Or a deeper entrance? This choice between escape or entrance is a constant theme. In Mabarossi, Koreeda's first film, Yumiko is haunted by her husband's suicide. While the context of death may deepen our sense of everyday life,It can also cast a blinding spell. While Yumiko slowly rebuilds her life, she cannot let go of her husband's death. One day, she follows a funeral along the coast. And here, Yumiko has a moment of truth. To the left is a consuming fire of death. and to her right, the silhouette of her new husband, calling her back to this world of the everyday. Yumiko chooses the world. In Koreeda's 2001 film, Distance, the choice between death and this world is made several times over, as each cult member makes a decision to leave their everyday life and participate in a mass killing. Like Afterlife, Koreeda tackles this extraordinary subject in the most ordinary manner. Cult members are not presented as strange or villainous, but as human beings longing for something more. One cult member begins to doubt, and like Yumiko, he faces his own moment of truth. Will he remain separated from this world and choose death? Or will he return to the world of the living? When someone runs in the films of Koreeda, it is almost always associated with his desire to escape or enter the world. The most moving demonstration comes from Koreeda's 2004 film, Nobody Knows. With the exception of Antoine Donnell's cathartic long-distance run in 400 Blows, it may be the greatest existential running scene in the history of cinema. Akira has been carrying the weight of the world on his young shoulders. His mother has been periodically abandoning her children, leaving him to take care of his younger siblings. Akira loves his mom, but when she's about to leave again, this time for good, he calls her selfish. She replies by asking, "Am I not allowed to be happy?" In pursuit of her own happiness, she chooses to escape her everyday responsibilities as a mother. Or maybe she equates the two. To be happy is to be free. For Koreeda, escape is always offered as a kind of fantasy divorced from this world. Whether it's Disneyland, religion, or one's own idea of happiness. Later, Akira has his own moment of truth. He also wants to be free and happy. So he tries to forget his siblings and live his own life. But unlike his mom, he is unable to detach himself. And so he runs, fueled by two competing desires. To escape this world that he has been carrying on his shoulders, and to be worthy of this world. It is here that we get a deeper understanding. The world is not simply some romantic postcard notion of life. It is difficult and sad, infused by death. It requires something from us. But the world is also full of everyday moments that mean something. Moments that connect us to one another. Moments that we'll remember forever. Moments that might very well mean the world.